Ready? Okay. Hey, we're going to make some French toast today. First, we're going to pat our audience. Now, I've been making French toast for 42 years. When I was 18 years old, I worked at Townhouse Restaurant. That's where I learned how to make French toast. What we're going to do today is teach you how to make Steve's world famous French toast. Now, first thing you got to do is not be afraid to break a few eggs. Okay? Now, we've already broke a few eggs here. We're going to break one more. Now, if you put any shells in there, CFS applies here. Now, you all know what CFS stands for? Can't fix stupid. Okay? So now we got our eggs in there. Now we want to whoop them up with a fork or a whisk. If you don't have a whisk, you're going to use a fork. Going to get them puppies real good and deep. While she's doing that, we're going to take some pancake batter. We've already pre-mixed it. And I'm going to throw a tablespoon of that pancake batter in there. That's going to kind of let it set a little bit. Kind of hold your French toast together. Also, we're going to add a little bit of cinnamon. I like cinnamon. Now, if you don't like cinnamon, you put nutmeg or whatever you want in there. Okay? Your spice, you choose. So we're just going to throw a generous helping in there. I think that's pretty generous. Could throw the whole thing in there, but that'd make a mess. Okay? So now we got that all whooped up. In the meantime, we're still heating up our oil, or we started heating our oil. Now, on our oil here, that's very important. You only want to put about a half an inch of oil in there. You don't need to drown them puppies, okay? Then beating them eggs, you're not making custard, so you don't need to beat the heck out of them. You just need to beat them enough where they're good mixture. Okay, now on the oil, like I said, you're going to pour about a half inch in there. Now, you ladies all know what half inch is, okay? So you know about how to measure that. You don't need a ruler. You don't need to stick a finger in there. Okay? So, now, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take Texas toast. We're going to have metamorphosis. That's what we're going to have. We're going to take French toast. Was it French toast? No. We were going to take Texas toast, and we're going to turn that into French toast. Now, how are we going to do that? Well, we already got our eggs, our batter's all mixed up. We're going to take us four slices of that French, or that Texas toast, then we're going to cut it, how do you say that, diagonally? Okay, we got to cut diagonally, and then we're going to just throw that in the eggs, okay? Now, go kind of dip that around in there a little bit, and then you're just going to go from there right into your hot oil. Now, this has been a good time to wash your hands. You really should have washed your hands before you even started, but nobody knows, okay? So, our next thing is, yep, just go ahead and, oh, very nice, very nice. Well, you learn quick. Look at that, ooh. Can you smell that already? Excuse me. Pardon? Pardon? Now, when you start eating this French toast, you're going to say, oh my gosh, it's going to be so good. Actually, I'll tell you what, it's going to knock your socks off. This is really super French toast. I guarantee it's going to knock your socks off. So, what you want to do is you're going to cook this about a minute on each side. Just until it's like golden brown. Now, we all know what golden brown is. Let's see. I don't have a golden brown here. So just think about a brown bear running through the woods. Now, that'd be a golden brown. So then you just roll them over nice and gently. I like to use tongs for this because it burns my fingers if I don't. Get them all nice and cooked up here. One thing about nice or French toast, you can have this for breakfast, you can have for lunch, you can have for dinner. You can have it for a midnight snack. Okay, we just about got us a batch ready here. Now, plate up. Let's see, what are we going to use for a plate? You know what? I forgot a plate. My gosh, We'll get us a plate here. Thank you, dear. There's a plate. How about one of them paper towels? Just one slice of paper towel. That'll just kind of soak up the little bit of oil there. Okay. So now we got a nice golden French toast here. See how that is? Nice and golden brown. Okay. I'm going to put that over here. We'll go ahead and plate these puppies up as they get golden browned. And then we're going to throw another batch in there. Now what you can do with these is you can put cherry sauce on them or strawberry or whatever kind of topping that you'd like to have on yours. Okay. There we go. Nice and golden brown. Look at that. Okay. So let's get somebody to sample one of these. Do we have somebody in the audience that would like to sample? Okay. Yeah. I'll let you go ahead and continue there, darling.
I'll sample.
You'll sample? Oh, thank you, Richard. You're a volunteer. Let's see. What do we need to get you to sample with? You want to just, picking one of these up? They're not really that hot. You can also sprinkle powdered sugar on them. They're real good that way. Might be a little warm there, Richard.
That's good.
Good. All right. Oh, those are just getting perfect. Okay. Well, I think we about made our French toast. In summary, what you want to do is make sure that you're not afraid to break some eggs. Okay? Make sure that you get some good pancake batter. You only need about a tablespoon per 6 eggs. And then a nice helping of spice. I like cinnamon. Again, choose your spice. And then you need the hot oil. Okay? Make a nice diagonal cuts with it. Fry it up until it's nice and golden brown, and then put your toppings on, whatever you like. Does anybody have any questions, or are we all good with that? How was that, Richard? Did that knock your socks off? Oh, look at all them socks coming at me. Oh. Okay, pan the audience, please. And I thank you, and bon appetite.